Hey, welcome back to the channel. I hope you're here to have some fun today. We're going to be working in Fusion. Recently, Casey Ferris released an entire tutorial set on making your own Star Wars fan film and how to do things like lightsaber tracking, as well as he gave a lot of free footage. I have links for those things down in the description, but the thing that I found that was missing was you need to have an open scroll if you're going to make your own fan film, right? So yeah, his footage is great, and I highly recommend checking out his tutorials. But today, in light of his footage, to just add on to it, let's just make an opening scroll, shall we? So yeah, I took some liberties. I watched a little bit of Star Wars, the first 2 minutes, and took down some notes on how the scroll happens. And we're going to just kind of work through Fusion. So if you want, you can go in, set up your project. It's a 24 frames per second is how it runs. And then it's a 2 minute long new Fusion composition that I have set up. And that's kind of where we're going. Right now, it's just a background note going into the things that I use to be able to record the screen. But we're going to just dive right in and see how long it takes us to make a decent opening scroll that you can pair with the free footage that Casey gave you. Anyways, we're just right here. We're gonna get started right away. Let's just go. The opening scroll happens in space. We're gonna drop that down right there and just make it black. We're gonna just bring in our first text node. We're gonna call this intro. Boop. And we're gonna type in a long time ago in galaxy far, far, far away. Dot, dot. Four dots, if you, I believe. It's unique. It's not a normal ellipse that they had going on there. And we're just going to go with a little bit of this. It's right there. We're going to go in and tweak this. First, we want it to be off to the side, and we're going to just move it around. Just kind of go, whoops, wrong one, right here. No, layout, there we go. Transform. I'm just gonna go, put it right here. Let's bring this up in the other viewer so we can see a little bit better what we got going on. That's better. Liking that better. So we're at our intro. It's right there. We're going to go with change it to News Gothic. Now, this is a font you can download from GitHub is where I found it. But the second you click it, you're like, oh, that is the font of Star Wars. I know that font. And then we're going to go with size. That's too big. I want to maybe make it a little bit smaller. And blue, just a nice light blue, and then it's a little sharp, so we'll just go with a soft blur. There we go, and that is it. That's all we need for the opening scroll, right? No, that's not it. So according to my notes, this title is only on for seconds 0 through 5, so that's, and then it fades off very sharply. So we're going to just go pop over here, type in 108, and drop a blend keyframe right here, and then we're going to go to 120. This is a 2,800 keyframe count, but it's something you can do, and it just fades out there. Boop, there it goes, nice and easy. And then we're gonna bring up and do this again. We're gonna take the same one because we already have the font and all that selected. And we're gonna call this logo. And so it comes in and says, oops, the wrong one. I'm gonna go to that, text. And yeah, so Star Wars. Star Wars, and transform characters. We want shading, so we don't want solid fill. We want it to be just an outline. And yeah, I was never really a fan of the red ones. I like the classic yellow, slightly burnt orangish. Right there. There we go. I'm going to just fix this layout here. Go back to text. Hit the size up right. Maybe make it a little bigger. We're going to go centered. And we're going to go back to offset. And in the center. Right there. That looks about where we want it, right? We're going to go with maybe make it a little bit bigger. Bring in tracking. Letters touch. And yeah, line spacing, bring that in a little tighter. And then they did fancy graphics. I don't have that. I mean, we could call this, since we're doing it for a Casey Ferris footage, we could just say, hey, Casey, you could have anything there. Casey's War. I don't know. Make it be. If it's your fan film, it doesn't have to say Star Wars. It could say Star Wars. Say whatever you want. And then from there, the letters are touching. That's good. That's good. That's the thing that we're going to want to do. So it comes in at the 17-second mark. So if we take our handy-dandy calculator and do 17 times 24, we'll hit 408. So that's where it's going to start. That's where 7 times 24. 7 times 24, 168 is where it comes on screen. But right about here, we're going to want it to be pretty quick. So we're going to go with 280 or 250. Let's go with 250. We're going to hit our first keyframe here. Boom. And then we're going to go back to 168 over here. And we're going to just go with, let's look at it. And we're going to just play with this Z offset. Nope. So we're going to go with 288, right around here. Drop the offset Z. And then we're going to go back to 168. And that's where we're going to scale up this offset Z till it is not on the screen. So negative, start with negative 3. Negative 3. Kind of just bring that in till we see it. Where is our start? There we go. Text, just making small tweaks. Right about there. That's looking good, right? So we're gonna go back to there, and then we have that keyframe set, and then we'll go to 480. So that's the 17-second mark, and that is where it's going to be very, very small. We'll make it small now. And just do 3. 4. And let's push it to 5. So yeah, that's our, you can look over here on the spline guy. That's our little spline. We actually wanted to just come in hot, So we're going to go straight linear. We don't want it to have any movement or slow down, so we want that to be smooth. It's going to go. And then it's going to speed up. Kind of want this side to. Oops. Control Z, option. Control Z. Yeah, I'm on a little buddy. Let's see how that looks now on our spline graph. There we go. So we have it and it hits there. Just want, kind of want to make sure that it hits that section smoothly. Technically, you just delete that out. And I don't click too many times. See. That flow set's looking good. And it's just gonna smoothly keep going off and shrinking in the distance. And then 480, we can kind of just round here. We can fade it out at the 19 second mark. So 20 times 80. It's 480. So 19 times 4. So 456. There. Our merge. Keyframe. And then 480. Alright, we'll just take that blend out. And there we go. That's two parts to our guy. Now we got the big one to go. Now that is going to be our scrolly guy. So we're going to really want that to happen. So we're going to just keep this all the same. And go over here, here, boop, drop that in. And now we're back to where we started. We're actually going to take and double that up. We're going to call, hit, and we're adding in just a couple nodes that I know we're going to use. So we have this one, intro 2, this is title, these guys up, just keep ourselves organized, title, and scroll. Alright, so the title, is this going to be, it's going to be yellow, that, let's just double that up, so we have the same color, I'm going to call that scroll, there we go, moving right along, that's not the right title. So we're going to go with Star Wars. Let's go with Episode 1V. Sure, because that's, you know, generally where things are at. We're going to hit center. Justify. I hate figuring out which one of these settings does. Oh yeah, because I had the offset here. I don't want that. Episode 5. go with. Casey's Hope. Ah, I don't know. What title should we give it since we're doing it for footage that Casey Ferris filmed for his thing? Let's just call it Casey's War. No. Casey's Battle. Casey's Resolve. Pop. There we go. And then we got the scroll. I did go and write something for this. You can write whatever you want to tell your story. But this is Casey's footage that he made to create a tutorial to help people out on making the fusion thing. And now I'm showing you how to make the scroll for that. So I'm going to use my text. So now we have a couple things to do to set up that text. We want to anchor that in the center. We want to put this back. Five. I want to bring in tracking. I want this to be left anchor. Let's add in two more paragraphs in each of these spots. All right. And then we're going to put these two together. So the title so wherever this title is, this needs to be lower. So we're going to go to here, to our transform, and we're going to just kill this offset. Oops. Make sure it's centered and drop it down and just get a feel for its spacing. Justification. Center that. That just makes life easier. There we go. That is how we want it. And in here with our offset, we're just gonna change the Z. Yeah. Just gonna get our spacing like that. How's that looking? Now we're getting somewhere. Casey's resolved. Blah, 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 da, 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 da. So we're at negative 0.725, just a number that we can remember easily is all that I want. Because we're gonna go here with our title, we're gonna pin that for now, pop it over to transform, and we're gonna say scroll is going to equal. So this is where we're gonna get into some expressions. So we're gonna just go doop. And we're gonna drag that to this one. No, we're gonna put our cursor in the box, drag it to this one. So we're gonna say title character offset point minus point, and we're gonna say it's 0.0 comma, we're gonna put in negative 0.725. Cool. Over there. Yeah, right. There we go. So we're minusing out that difference. So wherever this title is now, when we go back to our title and hit into our X offset, they stay together. They are linked by that expression that we did up here. So we're going to turn off that pin. We don't really need that. That's just to make sure that I can see it. Now we have over to this transform node, so it's not the XF one, it's the other one, and that's just going to be able to let us do our pitch. Whoa, because we want it to be pitchy. And we're We're gonna go back to our title. We're gonna just scroll our offset up. And you can see, yeah, right about there. We're gonna look at the main box of text, and we're gonna kind of just see where we're at. Now we might have to make some tweaks in here just to the line spacing. And stuff like that. And we'll make some tweaks. So in our scroll, we add that. That one go. Maybe just bring this up to 5. Oops. How about a 6? That looks about right. It's looking good. So that comes in like that, and like that. And like that. And then if you did the math, our scroll goes from the 7-second mark to the 17-second mark. It appears on the screen at this mark, so we can go down to our shading, to our transform, and we're gonna just scroll this till it gets off screen. And hit our keyframe, and then we're going to do the math. So that is 60 plus 27 equals 87 times 24. That's a lot of keyframe. Distance 2083. And that is where it should all be gone. So now we'll just scroll till it is gone. You might want to just tweak that. Maybe it's a little bit steeper. And then, yeah, one other thing we're going to do is put in where it goes off. We're going to put in a rectangle, invert that, soft edge, and then we're just going to put that up yonder, right around there, where it fades off at the horizon. It's just fading off. And there is your scroll. And that only took a little bit of time, but it works and it is functional, but that's no fun. Now it's just a blank screen. And this is where we're gonna get crazy now. We're gonna just drop in nothing. This is my nothing macro, so it does nothing. We're gonna give this that as its new background. Take this background, just so we know that that is a nothing background, and we're gonna go with boop, boop, boop. We're just gonna come, bring these guys around. Ah. And we'll call this under A. Hi. Oh yeah. Third time's the charm, right? Huh? You don't agree? Alright. Now let's get fancy. Now we're going to look for snow, because that's the easiest one that I know that does the thing that I want it to do. It's a template, so it is nicely set up, but we don't need it to flock, we don't need it to turbulent, and we don't need it to go anywhere. And we're going to say, we're going to change a bunch of settings. Let's see here. We don't need any velocity, inheritance. We're just going to play around with where things are at. We're gonna change our camera. It's not out now. we're gonna go with 50 meter millimeter. I'm just gonna get, be able to have it go far. We're gonna go here and look at that. Click on our thing. I'm gonna just change our style, our region. We're gonna make it wide. We're gonna make it tall. We're not gonna give it much depth. I'm gonna push it back off of our camera a bit. There we go. And we're gonna make it taller. So there's that. Well, let's think. So we have a really long composition. We're gonna do, let's see. Let's change our style. And then we'll switch to brush, flake. We're gonna select. Let's not have, let's have stars of seven sides. How's that sound? Just see if we can start to see some signs. We might need to be somewhere. Let's go with, I had a lifespan of 25. There's some stars in the sky, the region. We're gonna go with style. Make them a bit bigger. Oops, it is not too big. We're gonna lower that region. Just at the top of it, right there. And that is some stars in the sky, but that is a lot of them. Let's just bring that down here so you can see what we're looking at better. This background goes black, there you go. So there's that. And then we're gonna just go to here and tweak a couple settings with how many get released in the control. So we can just go here and hit maybe 5. That looks like a lot of stuff. Oh, that's the thing that it didn't do that. I do that every time. You need to tell it that it is the good resolution. So yeah, I don't know. Is that too many stars in the sky? So that's kind of where you get to play around with, is tweaking this number here. But the thing is, because it's such a long composition and the stars don't move, once we have kind of settled on how many stars we want, we're going to go to just kind of go to frame 300 and go to the first frame. It's a long time ago in a galaxy far away. There is no stars. And then between now and we see them start to pop in. Like that. Don't worry about that little flash to purple. It gets solved as when you do render. I haven't had an issue. It's just a thing. Bloop, bloop, bloop. Stars are appearing at that frame. The stars will stop. And we don't want it to keep doing its silly, goosey thing. So we're going to tell it to be done there on frame 301. But the problem is that anywhere past that, we don't have any stars, so we have to tell it we want frame 301. So we're just gonna go with time machine 3D, and that's a plugin off of Reactor. And we're gonna say we want to lock the end at source end frame 300 and the source start frame there. And so now we should still get our populating stars, and then it freezes out that star field. So there are no more stars getting added to the star field. It is just what it is, and that is looking good. So yeah, now you got stars to go with your scroll. You can kind of set that off and go bloop, bloop, bloop. That's our stars. in the sky. So now, let's, you know. What else can we do? We can have a lot of fun, right? We can go with, so we have our notes at the 127 mark. 5 seconds later, the camera abruptly begins to pan down. And so we can go and actually model that in and go, we're at 87 plus 5, that times 24, 2008. And we're going to go with our camera here. And we're just going to go transform, and we're going to rotate that X. And it pans down for a good 10 seconds. So that's plus 240 is 2448. Now we're there. And we're going to just pan our camera down like so. Maybe a negative 30 degree angle. How about that? I mean, I guess we could have moved the star field up, but the camera panning down feels just that little bit more organic and fun. So now we're here, but it pans down to what? And that needs to be a shape. So we're going to start with just putting the shape in here. It's a little dirty. So this is our stars. That is a square. You don't want that. You could put different things in space where you want it, but right now we're going to start with the main one, which is a star. No, well, sphere. Make it smooth, make it big, and we can see where it's at in relationship to our camera over here. And just line it up with our camera better. And we just want it to gotta make that a bigger. The bigger you make it, the more domish that is. And that is looking good. So we're gonna go back to our effects. We're gonna stop searching for snow there. I'm gonna just type in planet. I'm gonna go pop that over here, and we're gonna just drag that into the green guy. And all of a sudden, we have our planet. So let's rotate our, so we're not looking at the North Pole. That's silly. So I'm just gonna rotate our planet till we find something that looks good. And you could leave it like that. That is perfectly okay. But in the planet settings, there are things like cloud density, so you can make it less cloudy. You can increase it, cause the land to be more goofy looking. And just things like that. Yeah, it's looking not too shabby. And then there are other things. So there is, a halo glow. So we can take that as a visual map. So let's do that. Let's just go with, just double up this chain here. And just do a render 3D. We need another merge. Let me just take that shape. And merge there. We're going to give it the same camera. I'm going to go over here. And now we got it. Just our planet. And we're going to go with transform 3D. We're just going to scale that up just a little bit. Settings, doing what I wanted to do. There we go. Oops. Let me just translate that up. Just match. I'll just reset that because I think that's all. Alright, so now we have that. And we can go with channel booleans. I am not the best at this 3D stuff, but I can find my way around decently. There's that. We can kind of just see that's just looking at our. This looks a nice little soft glow, and we're gonna just go with X glow. And we're gonna just pump our background into it. There's the kind of X glow. We actually want a different background. Control down here and let's just see what we have. Going into there is white. There we go. And I'm gonna just change this to bluish. Silly goose. There we go. Silly goose. I had it on. Let's pop it over and see what we're looking at. That's a lot of glow. It's more glow than I want. So we want to dial back that matte control a little bit. Way too much blur. And we're gonna go with transform right there, and we're just gonna lower that back down. Switch this to under, I think. Over. I want to switch the order. There we go. And we can just tweak our matte control maybe a little bit. Blurry. Just like that. Now we're cooking. Now we got a little glow going on. So let's just clean up what we did there a little bit before we get confused. Yeah. That is a slight problem, I see. Let's leave that off for now, but now we have that. That's going to take some little tweaks to get that figured out of to not to have it be behind Starfield. So that the stars aren't, or in front of the starfield for some reason. I have it so that I have some stars that are in the way of my glow. Because those stars aren't a clean mat. But we could switch that if we wanted to. We want your stars to be something else. Such as flakes. Ha! Yeah, something like that. And then we can, there's all sorts of tweaks. Close size, we can take down the gain. Just a very soft glow. That is kind of looking more like what we have in the original movie. It's just a soft blue edge to the planet. And all we did was make a mess of our 3D. That's the one thing I don't like about 3D nodes, is it just makes a mess of organization and figuring out where and why things do things. And that's probably why I don't like working in 3D at all. It's not fun. It's a confusing mess. But we're at this point. We might as well continue on. If you get crazy because you got this far and you want to continue to make the replica of the scroll, we have some time left on the clock, and that would be that we can add in fun things that you can get on, like, Sketchfab. So there are a lot of really great 3D artists that have already done lots of really cool things. And so you can just go and find things like a USDZ file or a Blender file. Then you'd have to convert that yourself. And, oops, we're going to go look at. We can go in and bring in Star Destroyer. And I'm gonna just give that view merge. And we're gonna give it the same camera. So we can just kinda, if we wanted to keep this clean, we can do instances of this camera. Just to keep things simple, organized. And pretty much, I mean, that is one of the things that I'll do often, is just make instances of things just so that it is just a little bit more orderly. And nothing changes. There we go. There we go. Now we're keeping things crisp and clean. Oh, that is a big Star Destroyer. You can see there is our camera. And so we're gonna need a transform. We're probably just gonna need to scale that down quite a bit. Not that small, silly goof. I'm gonna take this shape for now. I think we can pump just the shape in and see where the sphere is and go to the renderer. Oops, merge. Oops, come on. Come on, little guy. Connect. Connect, connect, connect. There's our camera, there's the look that we have, and there's our Star Destroyer. And we're gonna put that so we have our glow. Technically, we want it to be able to pass behind the sphere, so we put it here. And now you would just then go in and rotate your Star Destroyer. Well, maybe we want it after. And we're just going to promise to not break things. So we would then twist over there. Let's look at where we're looking at here. It's there. Let's just go with. You can see it here. We can go above our camera. And we're going to just tilt it down. And theoretically, it should fly into view if you were to. So big. So it's about right here in the timing, so that's generally where we'd be. At the timing is where you would want to be able to be like, all right, there it's in position, my Imperial Star Destroyer, and then your keyframe, your rotations, and other positions, and then figure out how to draw. Here it is there, relative to the camera. You can go back to your early spot where it's supposed to come into the frame and you start off. And then as you watch through that, you should see it start to enter frame. And things like our rotation might need to be tweaked. Elevation might need to be tweaked at this point. It's kind of just at this middle point of your animation. Figure out where you're supposed to be. And there you go. And then we'll add in a distant light. To our scene. Now we can see our distant light is here. We're going to just put it generally. Oops. I just want the distant light. I'm going to put it down by thingamajigger. I'm going to rotate that till it is pointed at our Star Destroyer. Let's go four up and just get it better. And we're gonna have to tell the renderer to pick the scene. And there you can see that we're now getting shadows and things like that. And we're gonna just cut that shape out. And there is our Star Destroyer with a very janky, initially placed 3D animation of it coming into frame. That, my friends, is the entirety of the Star Wars scroll. So if you had a chance and you downloaded Casey Ferris's footage and learned from him and camera Tim how to track lightsabers and make your own little Star Wars fan film, you can now make your own Star Wars scroll. So hopefully you enjoyed this full little tutorial walkthrough to make it, because yeah, and there's a reason for all those keyframes, because you can, yeah, it won't be great for licensing rights and things like that, but you can go and get an export of, oopsie-daisy, we don't want a Star Destroyer there all the time. Should take rid of that. That doesn't appear till later. Let's go back into Fusion, fix that real quick. Why is there a Star Destroyer there? Doesn't need to be there too. Oh, that's because the camera pans up. The camera pans down. Then the Star Destroyer is not a thing. It's a and then, yeah, then we forgot to do that. So yeah, you can pair it with music. Probably going to use the rendered version for at this point. But anyways, that's how scroll gets made in all in one Fusion composition. You could break it into little bits and pieces, but we did it this way. Fun. I'm glad you enjoyed. And so until next time, do all those YouTube things like and subscribe. Algorithm happy. Farewell.